ओके, सीवियरिटी ऑफ एस3 कैन बी जज बाय
ड्यूरेशन ऑफ
नॉट
बीमारी,
एस3, सीवियरिटी ऑफ, यार सीवियरिटी ऑफ एमआर इट इज, सीवियरिटी ऑफ एमआर इज जज बाय, व्हाट यू टेल मी, इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द मर्मर, ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द मर्मर, एलवी एस3 और लाउड S1.
ड्यूरेशन सर,
It is a pan-systolic murmur, man. What you will get, the whole systole is engulfed. I am talking about this, scribble this, it is MR. Severity of MR can be judged by intensity of the murmur, okay, I will agree. Duration, I don't agree because whole systole is anyway engulfed. What do you want to measure in that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. This is correct. What about LVS3? There are two answers for this actually. So, see, intensity of the murmur is also true and LVS3 also true. But loud heart sound is not a feature of MR.
It's soft.
What?
No, yeah, loud S1 is wrong. Yes.
Loud S1 is wrong. Duration of the murmur is also not correct.
Yes, sir.
This one is MR. Okay. Otherwise, if I turn this as MS, I'll make this MS now. I'll change the question. Severity of MS is judged by. Now you tell me. Then this is wrong.
Yes, sir.
It is actually a question of MR. I don't want to change the question and confuse you. Severity of MR can be judged by. Intensity of the murmur and LVS3. Okay.
Yes.
These two are wrong. This is MR. Then severity of MR, all except presence of MDM. Can you get MDM in MR?
Yes, sir.
Can you get? Yeah, you can. Because it is a functional murmur.
Yes.
What are functional murmurs? Walls are normal, there is more blood flowing through it. You got it? Because the more blood has gone into the left atrium, the more has to come out. All the wall diameter area is normal, because there is excess blood flowing through the mitral wall, there can be mid-diastolic murmur in MR. MR we get pan-systolic murmur. But there can be MDM because as a functional murmur, you can be there. MR can have. That happens with the severe MR.
Yes, sir.
There can be associated MDM. But MDM is classically you read with MS1D. I know, I do agree. But MR also can produce MDM if there is very severe MR. It can produce. And widespread second heart sound?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, because wider the second sound, because lot of blood is going to left atrium. The left ventricle is emptying early. So A2 is moving more earlier, A2 is coming more earlier compared to the P2, so we are getting splitting. So this also is correct. Then LVS3, this is correct, you know that.
Yes.
Intensity,
yes,
of systolic murmur.
It's
correct. So none of the above. Yes, what is the answer? None of the above. Yeah, none of the above. Now MVP, to accept mitral wall prolapse. Is it autosomal dominant? Autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, or non-genetical? Genetics, what?
Mainly Marfan syndrome, sir.
Yeah. What are the other names for MEP? Barlow syndrome.
Barbos syndrome.
Barbos
syndrome.
Yeah. Autosomal, it is autosomal dominant,
Yes, sir.
Majority of the present with mitral regurgitation. Is it true?
Yes,
okay.
Yes, sir.
All leaflets show rhizomatous degeneration. And transient ischemic attacks. Which of them is untrue in this, of the four?
The transient ischemic attack.
Transient ischemic attack may occur.
Transient ischemic attack.
This is wrong.
No, sir, that is correct. It can occur.
It's related to stroke, sir.
Yeah, you say there is, there is a
TIA may occur in mitral wall prolapse.
Yeah, this is correct then. This is not the answer. Then wall leaflet mm-hmm. show maximal degeneration. This is also correct. So what you are left with these two. Majority of them will present with MR and autosomal dominant. Which of these two?
So yeah, majority present is correct.
Is a benign condition. There is no MR. Only few people will have MR. Okay. If your many of your friends will have MEP. What is MEP? What is MEP? What is MEP? Mitral wall prolapse means what it is.
Mitral wall prolapse.
So in MEP, now one of the wall leaflets will be very long. One of the wall leaflets will be very long. And because the wall very long, it will become flabby. It will flabby. If it is too flabby, sometimes it points like this. It will be, there is a leakage here. Sometimes. More often, it is benign condition. Nothing happens. So majority will not have MR. Only few will have MR. Okay. So if somebody comes with the echo report of MEP, don't jump and start worrying. Majority will have nothing. Yes, it will be echo finding, they'll tell the patient. Okay. If this associated MR, that too significant MR, then only you should advise infective endocarditis prophylaxis. That's all you require. If the MR is severe, then they may require wall replacement depending upon that. But usually MEP nothing happens. Read about MEP because this comes along with dynamic consultation. They will ask these questions. It is favorite because MEP is a very common condition, but more often benign.
Yes, sir.
The MEP causes are there in young age, young females, it is autosomal dominant. This myxomatous degeneration is there. Old age, they come with calcification, all that. There are types, you read about them, MEP. They can ask you questions. Angina and syncope are seen in AS, AR, MS, MR. Where you get angina?
Aortic stenosis.
Aortic?
Stenosis.
Stenosis, good. Aortic stenosis is classically they develop angina and they can develop syncope. These are very cardinal features of AS. Patient of valvular heart disease presenting with angina, syncope, you think of AS. Aortic stenosis. Okay. That is because the aortic, the systemic blood supply comes through aortic wall. If that is blocked, then the blood supply will be less. So because of that, you may develop syncope and angina. Angina is because of LVH and also LVH, because of LVH basically. Demand supply mismatch. The coronary arteries will not be able to meet that. There could be associated coronary artery disease, but usually you can put it as LVH for angina and AS. Because of the concentric hypertrophy. Even in AR, they can develop angina. How? Because the flow into the, this is the coronary arteries will come here, the heart will be somewhere. So if there is a lot of blood going, falling back like this, the flow in the coronary arteries is during diastole. If the blood goes into the left ventricle very fast, the blood going into the coronary arteries, there may be less. So AR also can develop, but good answer is yes. Take this. All that. You don't worry about this. Maybe if you don't get some choice, you can pick up them in that question. Sudden death is common in yes, MS, MR, AR. Which one? Yes. Because LVH is there. It is prone for arrhythmias.
Yes, sir.
So left ventricle hypertrophy is one of the risk factors for ventricle fibrillation. Okay. So AS patients are known for known to have sudden cardiac death.
Yes, sir.
Let me ask you this question. So, severe to the aortic stenosis, wall diameter?
Sir, less than 1.5.
Severe aortic stenosis, 1.5, 1.2. It is this, okay?
Less than 1.5, sir.
Even mitral wall prolapse, mitral wall orifice, area less than 1 and aortic area less than 1 means severe. Both mitral and aortic. And usually, then they may ask you gradient. CVS, what is a gradient? Mean gradient. There are two gradients, peak and mean. Gradient means the pressure difference between the left ventricle and the aorta. What is a gradient? If the mean means average gradient during both systole and diastole, they'll average it. That mean gradient, if it is less than 20, it is mild. 20 to 40, it is moderate. More than 40, it is severe, mean. If they're looking for peak, this is usually we look for mean only for aortic. Don't get more values in head. 20 to 40 is moderate. More than 40, mean is severe. Less than 20 is mild. That is for severe aortic stenosis. So, which of the following is contraindicated for treatment of aortic regurgitation? Tell me. Can you do diuretics? In aortic regurgitation, can you give diuretics? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If there's heart failure, you have to give. You can give what is wrong in that. Sodium nitroprusside? If there's very high BP, you can give that. And intra-aortic balloon counter pulsation and surgery. Surgery, if it is required, they can. See, one more thing. For the surgery, stenotic diseases are difficult. They have a higher risk compared to the regurgitation reasons. Okay? Like AS, MS, then maybe severe PS, TS. These are more risky for any surgery, not cardiac, non-cardiac surgery also. If the patient is undergoing hernia surgery, abdominal surgery, any limb surgery, if the patient has got these stenotic lesions, they are more risky. But regurgitant lesions are usually they tolerate. And pregnancy. So these things, regurgitant lesions, the patients usually tolerate well. It is a general rule you should remember. In that context, they have put surgery here. So, aortic regurgitation patients can undergo surgery compared to AS. If there is severe AS, severe AR patient is more safer than severe AS. That's what it is. So, surgery is okay. So, what is this intra-aortic balloon counter-pulsation?
During the heart failure.
They'll keep a balloon here, inside the aorta here. This will dilate in the diastole. And thus, it will increase the flow, systemic flow. Usually, when patient is in severe shock, we use this. To perfuse the organs, we use this. Okay. If the patient is in severe shock, like a cardiogenic shock, we keep
this. But heart failure also we can use.
Aorta, we keep it. Again, what? What, Rochan? I didn't get it.
Sir, in heart failure, we can also use it, sir.
Okay. Heart failure, you can use. Severe heart failure, you can use. I do agree. Heart failure, severe, we can use. But, see, what is the mechanism you should remember? So, this inflates in diastole. Thus, it augments diastole. So, if the pressures are increasing in diastole, as AR is a, this occurs in diastole, you will increase aortic regurgitation.
Yes, sir.
Okay. In a patient with aortic regurgitation, the diastolic period or diastolic pressure should not be increased. So, beta blockers, they increase diastolic period. So, they may in fact cause increased AR. One beta blockers. Similarly, intra-aortic balloon counter-pulsation increases diastolic pressure. So they increase AR. So beta blockers are relatively contraindicated in patients with aortic regurgitation. You're getting my point?
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Yes, sir.
That is important because they can ask you, they can, instead of this, they can put beta blocker here. But of course, this is associated heart failure, you can. But you should know that in aortic regurgitation, avoid beta blockers and avoid intra-aortic balloon portal pulsation. Pulmonary stenosis is associated with which all? Subaortic stenosis, Takayasu. What is Takayasu? What is Takayasu? It is all origin of this aortitis basically. This is aorta, arch of aorta. You get a innominate artery here, then carotid here, then subclavian here. Fine. These openings now here. There is a block. Okay. Inflammation and block. Okay. It has no business with the pulmonary stenosis. Pulmonary stenosis doesn't cause it. Okay. This is Takayasu. It is also called as pulseless disease. Okay. Because there is a block here due to inflammation, yeah, they can develop this. And these patients are also called as pulseless disease. That is Takayasu arteritis. Williams syndrome, supra-aortic stenosis it is, with hypocalcemia, some face like, and all things. You read about Williams syndrome. It is not associated with pulmonary stenosis. It is supra-aortic stenosis. And coarctation of aorta, nothing, no concern to pulmonary stenosis. Then rubella. So Williams syndrome, pulmonary stenosis, peripheral pulmonary stenosis possible. Okay, this is... Rubella, can you get maternal rubella is associated with pulmonary stenosis as a complication. It is a teratogenic effect of rubella.
Yes, sir.
Teratogenic effect of rubella infection in the pregnancy of the mother, they can develop pulmonary stenosis in the children. And Williams syndrome also can cause peripheral stenosis. Yeah, this is the answer. Two answers are there. Williams syndrome and this. Now, most common cause of TR. Rheumatic heart disease, LADRD, RV, CAD, endocarditis, is the IV drug abuse. IV drug abusers, they develop infective endocarditis on the right side or left side. Akash.
Sir, right side, sir.
Yeah, right side. Correct. Because they push it into the veins.
Veins, sir. Directly into
the bacteria will go into right side and go into right side. Now, these patients are prone to develop right side endocarditis. But that is not the cause of a common TR. It is usually because dilatation of the RV. Dilatation of RV is many more common compared to these.
Like a stupid.
So dilated RV is a common cause of TR. Okay. So what is Kavanaugh's sign? See, Kavanaugh's signs, there are two, post-systolic and diastolic. You should remember this. Okay. You can have a systolic murmur which increases with inspiration. You can have a diastolic murmur which increases with inspiration. I gave you the answer now. So right side events increase with inspiration. So diastolic murmur, Kavanaugh's signs could be both systolic murmur, and there are two.
Regurgitation.
Both TS will cause MDM, which is diastolic. TR will cause pan-systolic murmur, which is also with systolic. So Kavanaugh's signs of diastole, where you get? In?
TS.
This is TR. Systolic Kavanaugh's sign is TR. Diastolic Kavanaugh's sign is TS. Okay. Remember that. So Kavanaugh's signs means you pick up the right side ligaments. They may not specify diastolic murmur, systolic murmur. Only thing you should focus on this increases with inspiration. Okay. Kavanaugh's sign. That's a what is Kavanaugh's sign all about. Both systolic and Kavanaugh's sign, diastolic, both are there. That's all. These are 10 MCQs. But tomorrow, I am planning to take another 15 MCQs in cardiology. I'll try to finish it off. Cardiology and move to respiratory system. Under half an hour, you take rest. Madam will take epidemiology MCQs. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.